You know, WI task force, huh? Oh, you can text 911. Changed since I've been in here last time. They mail these out everywhere. Did I ask for your service? Okay, thank you. If you're just joining us, we're inside the wolf's den, the lion's den, inside the Janesville Police Department. They have this little public notice that you probably have to come to the Janesville Police Department to get. I don't know if they mail these out to every taxpayer out there, but I just come in here to see what this is all about here. Offer to comment by calling. This was yesterday, so I missed it. That's because it's not ready or available. I guess you gotta go looking for all these public notices. This is the bus fucking thing. Services to individuals who are experience homelessness and serious mental illness. Yeah, more place for notes than any. Assistance in Transitioning for Homelessness, PATH. It's a federal grant program created in 1991 under the McKinney Act. And they're administered by the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration, SAMHSA. Yeah, the first part of anxiety is to face your fears, so that's why I'm here. Let's face the fears of the Janesville Police Department thug mentality. So I come down here to read some pamphlets they got to offer. See if they can, what they offer for help in this community, other than abuse and extortion. But so far, they got a little pamphlet for homelessness, federal funded program. Let's see here. Connect with the Janesville Police Department. So they got an app you can join if you if you're a bootlicker and you want to connect even more with the Janesville Police Department, here you go. Let's see what else they have here. Job box, public box locations. All this must be where you can drop off your unwanted drugs. So the Janesville police won't catch you with them. Yeah, gee, politics and religion. Yes, very serious. Serious mental illness. What's this? Mental health division. It's empty. This was the only one there, so they don't keep up with the mental health shits, and then the homeless too. But they got stacked full of list transfers and connect from Facebook and all that other bullshit, but not enough for the mental health to help you with. So I'm gonna leave that there in case somebody else wants to. But look at the stack of bus fucking passes, and then the help for homelessness, and then the stack to connect. So Ward Janesville. How come they haven't got a reward since 2018? This guy likes impeding traffic and shit like that. He likes to stop you at crosswalks and shit. Yeah, well. It's all these indoctrinations with kids and shit, every picture. You don't see them with the real community as adults. They gotta get the teenagers and the kids to brainwash them and shit. Rescuers. Oh, they got some more over here. Oh, look at. Oh, they even got a resource guide. Look at. The funds must have been too short for the copy machine, because they still don't have too many of them. And then on this side, circle of care. Yeah, see, even you don't care about child abuse either. See, now we got two pamphlets here. Improving Highway 11. It's dangerous to ride a bike in Janesville if you don't pay attention. You got an ATM fine box in here. Pay fines and shit. This is where they do interrogations now. It's conference room.
How's it going? You need any assistance?
Did I say I needed an assistance? No. Okay, then fuck off then. Then fuck off then.
Okay. Okay. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too, man. I know, yeah. These guys are having like a special meeting and conference. They should have the windows covered if they don't want people to come in here. This is an interview. So this is how you get rid of all your drugs here. This is good education right here, huh? What is this? This education. Yeah, staged event. Yeah, probably. Like, who comes in here and does this? Who reads this? They just put this out here and say they did it. It's nothing but bullshit. See here. Right, can reuse them and sell them on the streets, yeah. Probably plant them on somebody and that's good. If they do reuse them, how many cops are just like, no one will know if I just take a couple Percocets, huh? Yeah, so this is all bullshit, but. He had a whole shit ton of drugs too, man. He was pulling in there. I didn't feel like watching him. I have to come back in here and look at this again, huh? Give me an excuse to come in here again. That's where all the dude's drugs that he even left some right there, see, so that people can reuse them. See, that's not really too safe, see? So, that's how they probably set you up. Or the cops come in here and snag the ones that are left over. You know, I don't know what kind those are, but you get a little closer. He was an older fella, so it's probably some heart medication, blood pressure medication. So this is definitely a danger. If any kid came in here and started digging his little hands in there, it's crazy, huh? Like, yeah, let's put a drug box in here where, you know, potentially people can come in here and do this and then not take care of it, huh? So, no needles, liquid patches, inhalers are a form of medicine, or other form of medicine. Like cannabis, you can't put cannabis in there because does that fall underneath the other forms of medicine? Yeah, that's why I came here, because I saw the chief of police fucking, he just left for lunch, so I figure it was safe to come down here, because the majority of the people are leaving for lunch, so. This guy looks like he's important. But, they all leave for lunch around this time, so it's safe to come around the cop shop because they're all on lunch. So, I don't know. Might go live again. Till next time. Nomad out.